Hey guys, welcome back to video number two. This video is all about setting up a CommCare project space. So first thing you need to do is you need to go to this URL, www.comcarehq.org/register/user. So once you've navigated to this page, enter your name, email address, password, which needs to include numbers or symbols, and a phone number, which isn't necessary. And then define your project space name. So I'm going to call my project space the demo project. And just click this box and press finish. Now it'll create your account, as well as the project space. And if this is your first time signing up for CommCare, you will get a free pro trial account for a period of 30 days. I'm not gonna save my password. And then it says, please visit the link provided in the email to activate your account. So please check your email, click the link, and we'll see you back shortly. So after having clicked the activation link in the email just sent to you, you should arrive at a web page that looks a little bit something like this. This is actually the form editor view, and it's something we will be diving into more deeply soon in the hands-on tutorial. But first of all, I just want to show you the dashboard and some of the features that CommCare has. So first thing we're going to do is we're going to go here to dashboard and click. So first thing we see on the left is applications, with our first application that just opened up for us. So we haven't given it a name yet, so it's called Untitled Application. There's a corresponding tab here that also shows all of your applications and the ability to create a new application. And an application is basically what we load onto the mobile phone or a mobile device, and it's a collection of forms that might or might not be interlinked. The second block on the dashboard is reports, and there's a corresponding tab on the ribbon above again. And these are just some reports, some pre-built reports that CommCare makes available for us. So we can see things such as worker activities, daily form activity, submission by form, and we can also inspect our data, so the submit history and the case list. And again, we'll go into more detail about what these are exactly, but they are very useful tools for monitoring your worker activity and ensuring that they've submitted the forms when they're supposed to submit the forms, and also delve a bit deeper into the data submitted, which is here, and the ability to correct data entry errors or load previously registered cases into the CommCare system. The third block, data, also has a corresponding data tab, and this is where we export our forms and cases. We can export data in CommCare in a number of different ways, mainly through CSV and Excel, but also as a HTML table, which we can then link to Power BI and ensure that we have automatic updates into our dashboards. Block number four then is users, which again has a corresponding tab here. And these tabs allow us to create either mobile workers or web users. And the difference between the two is web users are roles that are created in order to administer our CommCare site here, as well as read-only accounts to read the data exported through CommCare. Mobile workers are accounts that are created to collect data. So once the application has been loaded onto a mobile device, those are the usernames and passwords that are entered in order to collect the data. So some other things that can be done through the users tab is the creation of case sharing groups. So if caseworkers or mobile workers are working on a project together and they need to follow up on each other's cases, that's where we would define a case sharing group. In addition, we can define organizational structure and organizational levels, which is something we will delve into at a later stage. So finally, at the bottom here, we have four more blocks. We have messaging, which again has a corresponding tab here, and this is all for SMS-based messaging. So this could either be in the form of sending SMS reminders to your mobile workers or administering an SMS-based survey. The second block of the bottom row is the CommCare Exchange. So this is where, if you are convinced that your application is so good that you must share it, then you can do that right here. And I'll bring you to a portal where it makes it very easy to, on the one hand, find other people's applications, but also share your own application with the wider CommCare community. Then we have the settings tab. This is where you can define your project and subscription settings, which is also possible up here. So if I click this, I can see my project settings and your current subscription settings. I mean, we can quickly have a look inside project settings to see what kind of options we have. But, you know, I can change the name of my project. I can set my default time zone, which sometimes can be handy with the automated updates. Then there's privacy and security issues. So you can restrict the Maggie staff access to your project space. And then some other options that you can set. For example, two-factor authentication. You know, if we're getting serious about data protection, we always should have this enabled. And again, requiring strong passwords for mobile workers. If we're working in areas where we're afraid that mobile phones might get stolen and hacked, then we should require strong passwords for mobile workers. And then going back, finally, there's the help site. There's some great resources out there. For example, there's some other tutorials. The layout of the form builder has changed quite a bit since the Maggie last changed or updated their help site. So some of these things might be a little bit out of date, but there's still a lot of resources here. Another great resource is their Google Groups site. So if you type in or search for CommCare Google Groups, it's basically a Google Groups for CommCare users where you can ask any type of question. And you can also search for a lot of questions. And I particularly like this when I'm confronted with errors or bugs, or I want to do something advanced. I always come to, you know, groups.google.com/CommCare users to see, you know, is there already an answer to my problem? And finally, there is the Maggie Academy. So just search for the Maggie Academy, click on the first link. This site also offers some great training materials. And one I really, really recommend that you do is this CommCare Fundamentals course. This will give you a good overview of, you know, some of the things we just discussed, and also particularly, you know, what is case management and how can we use it. So that's the end of this video. You've set up a CommCare project space and learned a bit about, you know, what the different buttons on the home screen of your CommCare project are, as well as finding out about where to go for some help resources. The next video will be all about setting up our BlueStacks.